my Google Merchant Center account got suspended.
Relax, we'll get it approved in this video. Let's go. Okay, so you received this dreaded email. Your account is suspended. How do you fix it? Okay, it is pretty easy. If you fix the issues in your account, then the suspension will be lifted and you can run your ads again. If not, your Google Merchant Center account will stay suspended and you'll need to wait till you fix it before you can start your ads again. Okay, so how do you fix this? You need to go into your Google Merchant Center account, go into the diagnostics and go through every single error and fix it one by one before you can get that suspension lifted. There will often be one big glaring error in there that's causing the suspension, like your whole website is down. So obviously you need to fix this one especially before you can get everything running again. Okay, I have a video that talks about how to get your Google Merchant Center products approved. It talks about how to get these errors fixed, and I go into a lot of detail and my strategy, which involves also calling Google. So I really, really recommend you check that out. I'll leave a link in the description to that video. Later in this video, I'm also gonna go through the specific errors that cause your Merchant Center account to be suspended. So make sure you stay on to watch those. Okay, so you've gone to that video, you fixed up all the different errors in your Merchant Center account. How do you then get it unsuspended? In your email that told you that it was suspended, there should be a link in there to contact Google so you can let them know to review it. If that link is not there, I'll leave a link in my description here on this video that has a link to a page on my website that has all the numbers for Google all around the world where you can easily call someone about your Google Ads and Google Merchant Center account and then get it approved over the phone. This is really helpful because you can also call in another country and call another Google, say wherever else in the world where they're actually open during those hours. If it's currently late at night and you're freaking out and you want to get your account approved right now, you can call them. Just call a different country where it is open. Okay, so sometimes they'll actually evaluate it over the phone and then reinstate your account. So that's awesome. Sometimes they'll say you need to wait for 3 to 5 days for this re-evaluation period. But at least by calling Google, you got that time started. So now you just have to wait. If your account is not reinstated after contacting Google, they'll tell you that you need to fix a few more errors. And that's cool. Just go and fix those errors that they have there in your account or what they told you on the phone. You can then submit a second request for approval and then you'll go through that process again. If your account is not reinstated after the second review, it will enter a cool down period of about a week. You won't be able to request another review, so you have to cool down and wait a week before you can request again. You will be able to see the cool down dates in your Google Merchant Center account in the account issues and diagnostics page. Be patient, it takes time and you don't want to rustle the feathers of Google, the great master in the sky and networks, watching our every move and the gatekeeper of our profitable shopping campaigns. I, for one, welcome our new Googly overlords. Okay, so let's now get into the reasons why your Google Merchant Center account was suspended. There's 15 reasons. The first one is inaccurate shipping costs. This is due to inaccurate information between your product feed or your Google Merchant Center account shipping settings and your actual product page or landing page or website. Just make sure that whatever's in your shipping settings in Merchant Center or in your product feed actually matches what you're actually doing on your website and how you're actually shipping to customers. It's pretty easy to solve. I have a whole nother video about how to set up shipping settings in Google Merchant Center. It's in the description. Check it out below if you want to learn how to do that. The second reason is inaccurate prices, inaccurate condition, and inaccurate availability. Just like with the shipping settings, make sure that your product feed actually has accurate information that's actually on your website. You can do this by just having a dynamic feed. And if it changes on your website and you're using something like a Google Sheets feed, then just make sure you update it. It's pretty easy. Okay, the third reason is incomplete contact details. Make sure that the physical address of your business, the contact number, and your email address are in the footer of your website or on the contact page. These should also be set up in your business settings in Google Merchant Center. I'll leave a link in the description to a video I did where I showed you how to set these up in Google Merchant Center and how to do it well. So please check that out. The next problem is delivery issues. This just means that you can actually deliver to the countries where you're displaying your product. The fifth one is misrepresentation of self or products. This is when you have untrustworthy promotion. So Google's telling you that the experience offered through your website is fraudulent or scamming or it's a bit fishy. Google's always checking to see if you're actually running a legit business. If they smell anything fishy, they're gonna flag your account until you fix it or show otherwise. The sixth problem is a policy violation where the user can't actually purchase. People need to be able to actually go to the site and make a purchase if you're advertising on Google Shopping Ads. If people can't purchase, I recommend setting up pre-orders, and it's pretty easy to do this. Just get an app that allows you to do pre-orders so that even if products are out of stock, people can still pre-order and pay you money for those products until they come into stock again. Okay, number 7 is the dangerous products policy violation. Okay, you're probably selling something like drugs, knives, guns, explosives, or anything like that that's kind of crazy for Google. I'll just leave a link in the description to the dangerous products that Google says are dangerous products, so check that out if you want to see if your products are on that list. Okay, number 8 is missing info about payment methods available. So can people actually purchase them with their card or PayPal? You're going to make this clear on the actual page. Number 9 is the landing page or destination URL is broken or down. This is a really common one, and it means maybe the URL is broken, maybe you've made the product unavailable on Shopify. Shopping ads need to go to a product page. You can't send them to the homepage, they have to go to a product page, so this is really important. So just be careful not to submit a page in your feed for a product that's a 404 page, it's a landing page that is broken or isn't finished yet, because Google's gonna flag that and it's gonna be an error. I'll add a link in the description as well that lists the landing page requirements for Google Shopping. Number 10 is missing or difficult to discover legal pages or clarifications. Okay, so you need to make sure all the legal pages on your website are there on your website and not in a sneaky little place hidden in some corner that they can't access. Examples of this include missing terms and conditions page, missing privacy policy page, and missing shipping and returns policy page. Very important. This shipping returns and policy page should have time frame of the refund option, who will shoulder the shipping cost when returning the product, policy for broken or defective products, policy for products that are not broken but the customer just wants to return it because they changed their mind. What are you going to do in this situation? And make sure that you use the language for the country of sale. Which brings me to the next problem, which is wrong language or currency. This can happen when you're submitting for multiple countries and the pages are in a language that's not supported in that country. So make sure that you use the language and currency that's accepted in that country of sale. I'll put a link in the description as well to a list of all the different countries and their currency and language that you should have in Google Shopping. Okay, number 12 is affiliate spam or abuse of network. Okay, Google does not allow landing pages that direct users to other irrelevant pages. You need to make sure that the buy now button is actually functioning for buying now. You can't have landing pages that then direct to the homepage, it has to stay on that product page. And you can't have stores that just allow business to business purchases. Customers should be able to buy those products. Okay, number 13 is unsecure checkout. You must have a complete checkout process. Make sure that your checkout also has an SSL certificate and make sure that customers have a back button that they can click to go to the previous page. This shouldn't be a problem in Shopify. It's all taken care of. Okay, 14 is inappropriate images. Okay, this can be triggered in weird situations and many times I've got past this and it hasn't triggered it. So it's something that you have to play around with and keep submitting your products and those product images for those products to see what you can get approved. Google's gonna flag you if you put promotional text or logos in your image. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. Sometimes it's beneficial to try and get them approved. You really have to test this out, but just understand the risk. I don't think you get your account suspended for this, but you could maybe. But often they'll just bounce it back and you just have to change the image and try again. Other common reasons for getting your account suspended on Google Merchant Center are asking for unnecessary personal details. The store is password protected, so people need to actually be able to access the store. And the store is not globally accessible. Okay, so there are the reasons for getting suspended. How can you avoid getting suspended in the future? Here are my tips. Make sure you check your Google Merchant Center account very regularly. I like to check it at once a day, often a couple of times a week. Just keep a close eye on it just in case an error pops up. You don't want to have an error or a product disapproval or your whole Merchant Center account going down and suddenly you lose sales for even just a couple of hours, especially with a high volume account. Make sure that your product feed is up to date, okay? I would recommend using a dynamic feed so it doesn't go out of date and things on your website don't change, but that don't change in the feed. So make sure you keep that product data feed up to date with what's actually real and on your website. A really easy way to not get suspended is to not sell prohibited items. And finally, make sure you take the warnings seriously. You can just leave the warnings in there and you'll be there and you won't get disapproved, but I recommend fixing those up and making sure you have none in your account at all times. Okay, that's everything for today. If you found this video helpful and it helps you direct you to my video that showed you how to get those products approved in Google Merchant Center, then please give it a thumbs up. I make a lot of content for you guys and that tells YouTube, hey, Sam is making good content that's helping out the people watching this video. If you have any questions at all about your account being suspended, please just leave a comment below. I answer every single comment as much as I can and every single day, so I'll be there to answer your question as soon as I can. If you want to see more videos just like this one, please consider subscribing and check out my channel for all my other videos on how to grow your e-commerce store. Apart from that, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.